Now we are just looking on the factors on which the rate of reaction depends. As you all know that the rate of reaction is actually, you can say, the change in the concentration of the the chemical species with the passage of time. So there are many factors which just affect the rate of reaction. Out of that, one is the nature of reactant, state of the reactant, temperature, catalyst and concentration. So these are the major five factors which actually affect the rate of the reaction. So first factor I'm just taking into consideration, that is the nature of the reactant. See, there are many reactions which occur at fast rate and there are many reactions which occur at slow rate. For example, magnesium plus oxygen, when we burn magnesium ribbon in oxygen, we get to have magnesium oxide, and you know that it is a fast reaction. But see, copper is also a metal, but when we burn it, it forms copper oxide, but it is a slow reaction. So that means, as you can see, magnesium and copper both are metals, but actually the rate of reaction in both the cases is different. In one it is fast, another is slow, because it actually depends upon the nature of reactants. That means the nature of the reactants, that how eager they are to form the product. The more is the eagerness in the reactant to form product, more is the rate of reaction, right? So as you know that in case of magnesium and copper, magnesium is more reactive and somehow copper is less reactive. So magnesium has more affinity to collide with oxygen and result in the formation of magnesium oxide, and comparatively copper has less. That is why the reaction is fast, and in this case the reaction is slow. So we can say that the rate of reaction depends upon the nature of the reactant, that how eager they are to just collide and result in the formation of product. More is the eagerness, more is going to be the rate of the reaction. The second factor is that the state of the reaction. See, as you all know, we have liquid state, we have solid state, and we have gaseous state. You know that the reaction occur faster when the reaction occur between the gaseous state, or means the, when the reactants are present in the gaseous state, and as compared to when the reactants are present in the solid state. The reason behind that, you know that the reaction, if we want the reaction to occur, the reactants must collide. And when the reactants should collide, they should possess the less intermolecular force of attraction. That is why they can move independently and they can just bump each other, right? So that we get to see in case of gaseous state. As you all know that in gases there is the weaker force of attraction, so they can move more independently. So that is why the reaction occur faster when the reactants are in gaseous state. But when we compare in the solid state, there is a kind of hindrance, you can say, that they just are their motion is just hindered, or the collision frequency just falls down. So that is why the rate of reaction also falls and the reaction becomes somehow slow in nature. So this is how we just talk about the state. It is not only the state. One more thing I just want to tell you. See, we have Zn plus HCl. Like I am writing two reactions, Zn plus HCl, Zn plus HCl. They are actually the reaction in one I am using the, you can say, the zinc strip, and the other I am using a zinc rod. Or you can say I am using a zinc powder, okay. And in the other I have a zinc rod. In both the cases, we'll get to see it will result in the formation of zinc chloride and hydrogen. But this reaction is faster and this is slower. What is the reason behind? Because it is the form also that matters. Because see, when the for the effective collision to happen, there has to be more area of contact, and that more area of contact can be happen in a powder form, not in a rod form, right? So that means the state also matter, and the form in which the reactants we are using also matters a lot. Third is the temperature. So temperature, I know, I think you're clear with this factor, because on studying the temperature, you must be aware that kinetic energy is the function of temperature. More is the temperature, more is the kinetic energy of reactants, and as they will have more kinetic energy, they will move randomly. That means the collision frequency is just going to increase, and when the collision frequency increases, then obviously the rate of reaction is going to increase. So this is what the factor temperature, that how it affects the rate. Next is catalyst. What is catalyst actually? You know that catalyst is a substance which just increase the rate of reaction. And one more thing, there are few catalysts which can decrease the rate as well, right? But like in many reactions, we use the catalyst as a promoter, not as an inhibitor, right? But still we do have, right? So what is the catalyst actually? Catalyst is a substance which can affect. So instead of using the term increase or decrease, we'll be using affect. So catalyst is a chemical substance which affect the rate of reaction without getting consumed. That means there won't be any change which which will occur in the catalyst, not in the form or neither in the amount. That means as in whatever form you add the catalyst, in whatever amount you add the catalyst, you're going to get the same thing. So catalysts just affect the rate of reaction. Now you know that how catalysts affect that rate of reaction. See, you know that it is clear in your mind that for the reaction to happen, the reactants must collide, right? And you know that all the reactants cannot collide because there is an energy barrier that has to be crossed. See, like this. So there has to be energy barrier that has to be caused, this thing crossed by the reactants in order to collide among themselves. And to cross this energy barrier, they need to have activation energy. So if they will possess the energy equal to activation energy, then only they will be able to cross that energy barrier. Then only they are going to collide with each other or breaking of bond or forming of new bond. That means the product is formed, right? So that means the all reactants, as we all know that the all reactants do not possess the same amount of energy, right? So some of them will have the energy equal to the activation energy and the few won't have. So that means some will be able to cross that energy barrier and the few will left behind. So that means now in this case, crossing the energy barrier, the catalyst actually helps. How? It actually lowers this activation energy. That means the minimum energy which is needed to cross that energy level, it lowers the activation energy so that more and more reactants can cross the barrier and they can collide with each other. And so that means the collision frequency is affected. And when the collision frequency increases, so obviously the rate is going to be increased. Or vice versa, we can see that when there is no catalyst, so that obviously the reaction rate is going to be down. As we can see that hydrogenation of oils, in that we use platinum or nickel. So when we carry out hydrogenation of oil in case of platinum or nickel, the reaction just speed up because they just lower the activation energy so that more and more reactant can cross the energy barrier to cause the effective collisions in order to form the product. Next we have is concentration. Concentration of reactant also matters a lot. See, I'll explain with an example. See, what do we have now? Suppose I have a beaker here and I have another beaker here. In this beaker, I have three reactants and in this beaker, I've got many reactants. So in which of the beaker, there will be more collision frequency? Obviously, in the one which will carry the more concentration, obviously the collision frequency is going to be more in that. So that means in this, the collision frequency is going to be more. So that means the rate of reaction is going to be faster in this case. See, one more example. I have a flask in which I have a zinc. I have another flask, again I have zinc in it. I have 10 molar HCl solution and in another I have suppose 20 molar HCl solution. I add it to it, I add, this is zinc. I add HCl to it, I add HCl to it. So what kind of change I get to see? That I get to see that yes, the hydrogen gas is liberated, but in this case the hydrogen gas liberated, the amount is less, but in this case hydrogen gas liberated is very high. The reason being the more concentration of HCl. So that means the concentration also affects the rate of reaction, because more is the concentration, obviously their rate of reaction is going to be faster, because more concentration means more moles per liter. That means more collisions, collision frequency are going to increase, so obviously the rate is going to increase. So this is what we have, that how the factors just affect the rate of reaction. I think it's clear that the factors are these I told you, and how they are just getting effect, I think you are aware of it. Now we'll be doing the next topic. That is the concentration, how it, we have a rate law depending upon the concentration, we'll be seeing in the next topic.